And we go to negotiation. And this could be the greatest defeat of all. You know, if the negotiations fail to disarm North Korea, and we continue this 20, 25-year pattern of negotiating to no purpose, and the North Korean program, the nuclear program, continues to advance, you know, we're just at that point. The reason it's being taken so seriously, there's still the military possibility of disarming North Korea. They haven't got that many ICBMs yet. You know, it's a small number. They do have a lot of medium-range ballistic missiles, so we probably would not be able to disarm all of those. But the ICBMs, they could threaten our homeland directly. And they've only got the two satellites up, you know, so that we, even if those are nuclear-armed, we could still take them out. But we're just at the threshold where if they get a little stronger, North Korea will become irreversible as a nuclear weapons state, and it'll be too late to try to reverse the fact of a nuclear-armed North Korea by war. And then we'll have to try living with a nuclear-armed North Korea. And that peace, that so-called peace, I think would be fatal to the geostrategic balance and world order that is built on American security guarantees, because they would no longer be credible. They would no longer be credible. You know, Japan and South Korea and our allies in the Philippines all understand that the United States could not rationally be willing to trade Los Angeles or San Francisco for Seoul or Tokyo. Certainly, they're not willing to trade losing 90% of our population to an EMP attack to uphold our national security guarantees to South Korea and Japan. So our security guarantees would no longer be, by cold calculation, militarily credible. And that would undo the alliance. That would undo the existing world order. And we would be standing at the threshold of a new world order, which would be dominated by Russia, China, North, and their client states, North Korea, Iran. And as Sun Tzu says, you know, the greatest victory, the best victory, is one where you do not have to fight a war. And that perhaps is the most likely outcome, where we basically do nothing, negotiations being doing nothing, and lose the opportunity to save this existing world order, to uphold security guarantees. It would be a transition in world history as stark and as dangerous, I think, as the end of the Pax Romana, the fall of the Roman Empire that then introduced the new Dark Ages. That's what a change in world order means. It's not some hypothetical political science idea. It has real human and historic consequences, usually terrible consequences. EMP especially brings on the prospect of literally a new Dark Ages that turns out the lights in America or over the whole world if it becomes a hard war. It opens the door to the new barbarians. Who are these totalitarian and authoritarian states, you know, represented by Russia, China, North Korea, and Iran, and the terrorists? And the terrorists. What a change from Francis Fukuyama's end of history, where we saw this road that was leading to the bright uplands of freedom for all humanity. And here, not that many years later, we find ourselves standing on the precipice of a new Dark Ages.
You're right. From Fukuyama's optimistic screed to where we're at right now, different. And it's rather humiliating to me as an American just to see where we're at. So just to be clear in my mind, and then I know, Joe, if you have a question, but just to be clear in my mind, the alternative to, well, okay, there's a chance we could work this out, but we're going to be on the losing end essentially of a geopolitical chess game, to because over North Korea to the client or to the states of or nation states of Russia and China. Ultimately, alternatively, we could be facing a war, the war, the conflict, whatever you want to call it, could very well be asymmetrically, tactically performed. And you're looking at an EMP cyber attack kind of thing, is what you're saying, if I'm hearing this correctly.
Yes, that's right. One of the other, let's talk now, we've been talking about asymmetrical warfare at the level of geostrategy. Let's talk about on the battle.